Daily Mussar from Sefer Chassidim. It says in Sefer Yov, "Vayochas tzadik derecho," and a righteous person will hold his path, his way. There is a person she'eno zakai she'ekabel makom tefilato. He is not, did not merit yet that Hakadosh Baruch Hu will accept his tefillah. Ella, rather, ba'avur tokef tachanunav, because he's begging. V'timat einav asher tamid bocher u'mitchanen, he always begs and asks God. Af al pi she'en beyado zchut u'ma'asim, even though his actions are not, he doesn't have anything to show for, or whether it's a merit or good actions, even though he doesn't have it, because he always cries and truthfully begs God, mekabel HaKadosh Baruch Hu tefilato v'oseh chefzo, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will accept his tefillah and do what he asks for. Im yishal adam davar shehu shevach lebor'o, if a person is going to ask for something that is of a praise to God, kegon, alimut Torah, or al davar acher mechafzei shamayim, v'shofech et nafsho alav, HaKadosh Baruch Hu shomei at tefilato, af al pi she'en bi'ado ma'asim tovim. Let's say a person does not have much to show about. But he's saying, Ribono shel Olam, please grant me with Torah. Choose me to become a vehicle to do Kiddush Hashem. HaKadosh Baruch Hu hears that, and you will expect. And you expect to accept. Question is, why wouldn't anybody ask that? Many people don't understand that even in Torah, the issue of kochi ve'otzem yadi could apply. I don't need to ask for anybody. I'm smart, I'll figure it out myself. Even in that, you need siyata d'shamayim, you need a kadosh baruch Hu to help you. So, if you don't zoche, you're not zoche, you're not merited for the Torah, either you're too arrogant, or you never asked. So now you're going to ask. Whether it's Torah or Kol Davar, it's going to be glory for Shamayim, ask, you're going to get it. Guaranteed. Im yishal adam etzah mimcha, if a person is going to ask an advice from you, Im yadata, if you know, hadrechel b'derech yeshara, guide him in the appropriate way. Lefi ma shenira be'enecha l'ritzon ha'makom. Interesting. Somebody is asking advice from you. Use the best, or try to guide him the best in your ability to do the appropriate thing to what God you think will say it's okay, not to what you think or he would think. That's called giving an advice. There are people who are known to be Baal Eitza, people who give good advice. Usually, they will be the ones who will guide you without their personal input on that. They say, well, you know, I think you should do that, because that's probably what HaKadosh Baruch Hu would want you to do. Rabbi, what should I do? Should I go on vacation to Bahama, or I should spend 2 weeks in Yeshiva? Of course, it's a no-brainer. You think God wants you to see half-dressed women in Bahamas? Not half-naked, half-dressed. No, He wants you to be here. Rabbi, should I go for 4 days to the Dominican Republic? Or I should stay for 4 days in Yeshiva? Of course in Yeshiva. Listen, Rabbi, my parents are going for 4 days to Florida, and then 3 days to the Dominican Republic. Then they're going to hop on to Guantanamo because they want to go to Cuba. What should I be doing? But what you'll be doing, invite some of your friends over for Shabbat. To the house for yourself, invite them for Shabbat. You know, some guys that you know that don't live in a place next to a shul, you know, bring them close. Do something. Give them a good advice. Don't say, well, you say, well, this guy is, it's a lot of money. I'm going to give him an advice that he's going to like me. Like this, he'll give money for the yeshiva. And will be more spreading motor. No, that's not the advice. You want him to do an avera? No, Kadosh Baruch Hu wants you to sit down. You have 4 days vacation. Habibi, let's learn. Give him a good advice. Everybody wants to go to this island paradise, right? Me too. I want to go to the real paradise. A real one. That's why I didn't go to the Caribbeans yet. I'm 25 years here, I haven't stepped in the Caribbean. Besides the Caribbean market, you know, that's about it. I like reggae. This is Caribbean as it gets from me. Jerk chicken is good. I don't need to go to Jamaica to eat jerk chicken. I can make aid. You want to get a sunburn? Not a problem. Come work in my backyard, pull some weeds, cut the hedges, and get something. I don't understand. You have to go all the way there, you crazy guys. And come, while you're cutting my hedges, I'll teach you Torah. You know, you'll cut the hedges and I'll talk to you. That's terrific. That's wonderful. Look at how many mitzvot you did. You cut my hedges, after le'recha kamocha, you learn where you work, you do this. You can't have a lama bad just cutting my hedges. Give the people the advice that God would say, good, that's a good advice. Not the advice that you would say, ah, I'm so smart. Give them, guide them in the appropriate way. But don't guide them, lefi darko keneged aborei, according to you, against what God says, against what you know is right. It's okay, you can eat not kosher outside of the house, you know, as long as your house is kosher. Now God doesn't want you to do that. I don't understand this. I keep kosher inside the house and keep kosher outside of the house. It's like a person would say, yeah, you know, yeah, my wife is very loyal to me in the house. Outside of the house, you know, she's not. You know, it's, you know, what can I tell you? That's the sign of the time. The same thing, you know, for me. You know, it's the sign of the time. A man got to do what a man got to do. I have a parnasa to worry about. You know, so inside the house, I'm 100% loyal to my wife. What kind of a thing is this? What are you, crazy? V'im tishtok, and if you keep quiet, v'ata yodea le'adricho, and you know how to guide him, pen yishal me'acher v'yiten lo yitzah shena ogenet, k'mo sh'asav shalom sh'asha'al yitzah me'achitofel, v'atan lo achushi yitzah v'nafal b'yidei avid. You can't keep quiet when you know what's the right thing to do, you keep quiet. Because if you keep quiet and you know that that's the right thing to say, that's the right thing to do, he might go to somebody else and he would stumble because of that. And that's on your head. God gave you, when you give somebody an advice and you want to do the right thing, HaKadosh Baruch Hu in a way opens this little flip in your head, you know, like a little door, like this. Sometimes it squeaks, you know, like this. The good advice goes in, like this, close it, comes out of your mouth. That's a good advice. So you know what's right. You know what's right. How do you know what's right? Because God told you this is the right thing to do. That's the heavenly voice. He tells you that's the right thing to do. And you kept quiet? Why? Because you were too concerned about yourself? You were afraid of your image? You tell him what needs to be done. Because if not, he's going to go to somebody else. And he's going to guide him in the wrong way. And he's going to be on both of you. I mean, it's going to be on you that because of you he sinned and you allowed the other one to do so. So it's like a double, it's a, I don't know, double whammy. It's like the jackpot of all heavens. You know, it's like goodbye and good luck. You know, better off. So say what you need to say. You don't have to yell at him. Just tell him, you know, I think this is what needs to be done. You think I should do this or I should do this? No, you should do the right thing. You told him. You have to guide him. That knowledge came to you. Use it. Yei Ratzon Shehakadosh Baruch Hu would help us, God will help us, to walk in the right path, and to help people and to guide them into the right path, so nobody should stumble, and we should be able to help those, anyone who needs help, Gentile and Jews alike. Amen. Amen.